Hey, welcome back to Tractor Tales, folks. This week we have a story of a classic Ferguson, part of a family collection in Illinois.
This is a 1957 TO35 Ferguson. A lot of people ask us, well, is that the right color when we go to tractor shows? And yes, it is the correct color. When we restore tractors, we're very particular. We want them as close to original as possible. I don't know why Ferguson decided to paint them this color. They started out, they were all gray, the TO20s, TO30s, and then in 1955 they came out with what is called the Green Belly TO35. All the cast iron parts were metallic green. The sheet metal was gray. In 56 they came out with the what they call the bamboo beige, is what this one is. And then in 58 they were getting ready to transition to Massey Ferguson, so they started painting them Massey Ferguson color, which was red and gray. When we got into this club, FINA Enthusiasts of North America, we found out that they made them in three different colors, so we had to have one of each color. My brother Les and I went to down by Mount Vernon, Illinois. Collector Joe Burke was selling off some of his collections, and so we bought this. All three of our tractors are retired, basically. We go to 4 to 5 tractor shows every summer. We have a plow for each one of them. If the show has the facilities to plow, we go out and plow just because we want to show them in their natural environment, which is working. We really enjoy showing them to the people, but we enjoy plowing with them too. The Ferguson tractors did not come from the factory with lights or bumpers or the stationary hitch. Those were added at the dealership, and so there were different variations, different type of light kits that they purchased to install, and so that's why the different lights.
Thanks, Greg. Well, just last week, we told you how economists say even with the double-digit increase in retail meat prices, shoppers are still forking over the extra cash. But is the same thing happening abroad? That's next.
U.S. Farm Report is produced and distributed by Farm Journal Broadcast.